So if you were in the terrarium building hobby like me, then I'm sure you would be interested to know about springtails. In fact, many of you who watch my videos on YouTube about terrarium building have reached out to me and have asked me to make a video on springtails. So here I am making a video, and it's going to be about springtails, how you can collect them, how you can breed them and use them in your terrariums. So what are springtails? The internet says that springtails are beneficial insects and they feed on decaying organic matter in the soil, helping with the process of natural decomposition. It also says springtails are associated with damp conditions and organic debris, and they are found outdoors in soil, leaf litter, decaying plant matter and rotting wood. They are found in diverse habitats from tundras to cornfields, and they feed on fungi, pollen, algae or decaying organic matter. So how does springtails help in terrarium building? Springtails actually help in arresting any fungal or algal growth inside these closed ecospheres. So once we set up our terrarium, before we close it off, if we add some springtails, then any fungal growth that happens within the next couple of days will be eaten up by springtails, and they will keep the terrarium fresh and will not let it rot away. So that's the main benefit of adding springtails to a terrarium. So unfortunately, I do not know anyone who's selling springtail cultures in India, so I have to go ahead and develop one for myself, and it's very easy. Even you can do that. So what you can do is you can go out into the forest and look under probably tree barks and bricks or stones that lying around, because springtails are usually available in moist and damp areas. If you're lucky, you might also see springtails growing under the flower pots in your own garden. So there are many ways of sourcing springtails. I have used some of these methods to source my springtails, and from there on I have just been breeding them and developing my own springtail cultures. So these are my two main cultures, and these are approximately a year old. I had started setting up this culture way back in December 2018, and initially the first 2-3 months I only had a couple of springtails, so it took a little time to take off, but then after that they really multiply very fast. In order to make a springtail culture, you would need a container like this. Any container will do, but it must have a lid. And you would need some charcoal. So I have already placed some charcoal inside this container, and I have rinsed this as well. So after that, what you need to do is you would need to add some reverse osmosis water, RO water, like this. Don't fill the entire charcoal with the water. You should probably fill halfway up to the level where the charcoal is. And then what you can do is you can take some springtail from the already established culture, and you can just dab them lightly and drop them into the new culture. Just a few would do, you don't need a lot of them. And once you have done that, you would also need to add some food for them. So usually what I do is I use uncooked rice. So this is what I'm going to give them as food. Now they will actually not eat this rice. Eventually there will be some fungal growth on this rice, and they will eat that fungus which is growing on the rice. You can also use yeast. Both of this will work. You just need to close the lid to retain moisture and prevent springtails from jumping out, as they have a spring-like appendage on their tails. Keep the culture in a dark place and avoid sunlight. And once in a while, I suggest that at least every alternate day, just open up the culture and just let in some air and close it back again. So I have probably dropped around 10-15 springtails in there right now.
and probably in a month's time they will start breeding and the cultures will take off and you will have a lot of springtails in no time, which you can then keep multiplying and keep using them in your terrarium bits.